We next have poster 46, titled Violence Seen on Facebook and YouTube, a Qualitative Study. The authors are Harshini P., Jayananda C., Hapuarachi N., Harshana U., Kularatna H., and Athaudu L. The presenting author is Harshini P.
Good morning, everyone. I'm Pubudika from Faculty of Medicine, University of Kalaniya. This is an undergraduate project on violence seen on Facebook and YouTube videos, a qualitative study. In recent past, we saw circulation of violent content on social media has been increased. So we wanted to describe violent content on Facebook and YouTube videos over 3 months of period. So we actively search keywords on search bars on both Facebook and YouTube using keywords in both languages, Sinhala and English. And the videos matched with the inclusion criteria were selected. It was purposive sampling. For avoid duplication of videos, we used the same Google folder for each member. So before adding a new link or new video to the folder, we check the link is already available there. If so, we remove the new one. And also for further confirmation, at the end of each week, we manually check by ourselves to confirm there's no duplication. Then data was extracted by data extraction sheets. From that, we did a brief quantitative analysis according to the types of violence and subject of the videos and according to views and reactions on Facebook. Then we, as the next step, we analyzed the content using descriptions. So this was done by two independent members of the group, excluding the one who searched for it to minimize bias. Using descriptions, we tried to identify important patterns, the common phrases, and most important and common content in this description. So then we summarized those data into themes. Here you can see on the poster. These were built by the repeated discussions after repeated discussions within the group and with the supervisor. So we saw violence was newsworthy. It was used as a marketing tool sometimes to sell their products, and it was used as entertaining tool, as short movies, prank videos like that, and it was used to used to raise awareness about violence. Lots of videos were there to show how the impact of the victim and how to seek protection instead of hide from social stigma. And response of onlookers was quite interesting. There were some experimental videos also, how to see how the reaction of viewers. So it was differ according to the place it occurs, like public or domestic violence, and according to the gender of the victim. So in conclusion, over this 3 month of period, we observed violent a lot. And in both media, we saw physical violence was the most prominent. And according to the reactions on Facebook, emotional violence got the highest reactions, and physical violence got most views in the YouTube. And violence was newsworthy, and it was used as an entertaining tool, and it was used as a marketing tool. Thank you.
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
So what are the keywords you use to search these violences?
So we used in English, the keywords were selected by the after discussions with the group. So keywords like bullying, fighting, shooting, stabbing, and also in same words in the Sinhala. We used 6 words in English and in Sinhala.
In the absence of further questions, please give a round of applause to our presenter.
Thank you.